Good morning everyone and welcome to JFD's daily market review for December the 14th. I am Charalambos, Head of Research here at JFD, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against all the other major currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained the most versus Aussie, CAD and NZD, while it decked out the least gains against the Japanese yen and the Swiss franc. Now, the relative strength of the safe havens dollar, yen and franc, combined with the weakening of the risk-linked Aussie, Kiwi and Loonie, suggests that financial markets traded in a risk-off fashion yesterday and today in Asia. Indeed, turning our gaze to the equity world, we see that major European and US indices were a sea of red, with a negative sentiment rolling into the Asian session today as well. Now, investors may have turned cautious again after the United Kingdom reported its first death from the Omicron coronavirus variant. Deaths from the new strain may have occurred in other countries as well, but there was no official confirmation outside the UK yet. Remember that last week equities rallied on news that the symptoms of the Omicron variant are not as severe as previously thought, but although we saw decent chances for some indices, especially the US ones to enter uncharted territories, we were reluctant to call for a long-lasting advance. We specifically noted that headlines pointing to more severe symptoms of the Omicron variant are likely to result in stress and anxiety again, and thereby another round of risk aversion. This is what happened yesterday, and bearing in mind that the news surrounding COVID have the potential to move the markets in either direction, we prefer to turn to the sidelines for now. Now, market participants may have also reduced their risk exposure in anticipation of the FOMC decision scheduled for tomorrow. Following the hawkish appearance of Fed Chair Powell before Congress a couple of weeks ago, investors are now expecting the committee to remove the transitory wording with regards to inflation from the statement and also signal a faster tapering process. Such a decision is hawkish by itself, but given that it is already anticipated, we don't believe that it would be the main catalyst behind the dollar's reaction. We believe that it may be the updated dot plot. According to the Fed Fund Futures, the financial community anticipates the first post-pandemic rate hike to be delivered in July next year, while it factors in another one before the end of the year. Therefore, the new dot plot needs to point to two or more quarter point increases for next year in order for the US dollar to gain. This could also affect the broader market sentiment as well, and thereby other currencies besides the US dollar. Some currency pairs we expect to experience some volatility despite not having the US dollar in the equation are the Aussie yen, the Aussie franc, the Kiwi yen and the Kiwi franc. In other words, pairs that consist of a risk-linked currency and a safe haven. Now, as for today's events, during the early European morning, we already got the UK employment report for October. The unemployment rate ticked down to 4.2% from 4.3% as expected, but the net change in employment revealed less jobs than anticipated. Average weekly earnings, both including and excluding bonuses, have slowed by less than forecast. In any case, the report passed unnoticed, as GBP traders may have been keeping their gaze locked on Thursday's Bank of England decision. Now, later in the day, we have the US PPIs for November, and similarly to the CPIs, they are expected to have accelerated further. Tonight, during the early Asian session, we get New Zealand's current account balance for the third quarter, while RBNZ Governor Andrea Orr will hold a speech. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.